It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium.
Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Baltimore Ravens.
And how about this? An onside kick to start the game. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. Well, there's two sides to every coin. You come on the road, you get the onside kick to start the game. What a boost, but you don't get it. And now your back's against the wall a little bit.
You're exactly right. You nailed it perfectly. And so many ways to go at it when you're on the road. You think to yourself, well, if we start on defense, we blitz them early, try and create a big play. If we start on offense, we throw the big pass downfield. In this case, they said, forget all of that. Let's do it on special teams and try and catch them off guard with an onside kick unsuccessfully.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Hey, middle. Right back to Mitchell on second down. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two, now third down.
You can bet they're not going to go away from the running game anytime soon, but this is obviously not a good start. Two carries, two runs, both stop for a loss.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Pass taken in. That was big tight end. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
We often hear the phrase shorthanded tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Now, after the loss, he'll have to navigate a second and 17. Play action. It's Jackson. And this is going to be pulled in by the tight end Andrews. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
First and goal from the three.
Mitchell. He'll take this into the end zone. It's a Ravens touchdown. Justin Tucker for the extra point. And the Ravens lead it 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
Kenny Nwagu now out of his end zone.
And he doesn't even get this to the 10. He's taken down.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
Cousins throw pulled in by Jefferson.
And he's going to be taken down right there at the 20-yard line. On first and 10, Cousins.
And this one right back into the hands of Jefferson. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a first down.
So we just called his name on the previous snap, and they go right back to him, Charles, for a second consecutive completion.
Yeah, I think what we're discovering on this drive is that he feels like he has answers no matter what defense you throw up there. He reads it, finds the open spot, and is available for the completion.
Now here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Play fake, Cousins. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. Handling out to the sack. It'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Now Cousins going to change it up. Now back to throw. And he's got this to Jefferson. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
Well, that's not just his first, not his second, already his third completion here on the opening drive. And I think it's safe to say that getting him the ball in this game, one of their top priorities.
And a top priority for the defense has got to be finding ways to cover him. And I don't think you can have one basic coverage to get it done. You have to throw a number of coverages at him, make him think as he's running downfield, and hope you can create a little bit of havoc.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Vikings with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a third down coming up. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. On third down, Cousins. This goes out wide from Madison. And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Throwing is Cousins. Gets it inside the 10 to the 7. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
To the air again, it's Cousins. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. Justin Marvico. Pretty high hit. That's going to go as a loss of 13.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, it took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
Second down, Cousins. This is Alexander Madison out of the backfield with it. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Here's Cousins. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
From the defender.
The offense stays out there. A big challenge here from this far back, but they're going for it on fourth and goal. To throw his Cousins. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. An 11-yard touchdown. And the Vikings go coast to coast and finish the drive off with 6 points.
Boy, what a job there. Fourth down that far away from the end zone just to get it in, get that done.
an unlikely result, but it occurred nonetheless. What a terrific play. Great way to finish and in the end zone.
And the defense has to be scratching their heads, right?
That's usually to their advantage. In that situation, they should be able to make a play on the ball. But instead, it turned out to be a touchdown. And maybe I go figure it out on their sideline.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line set to get going.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
They'll get this to Flowers, left side, and past the 40 before he's out of bounds. His first catch of the game, good for 11 and a first down.
But that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Play action. Now Jackson. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
At this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Off the play fake, here's Jackson. Rush coming, and he's taken down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Jackson. Flush to his right. Pressure gets to him again. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Vikings will take over here first and 10. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball. But he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
They go play action. Cousins. Going underneath, he's got Hockenson. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Cousins now to throw on first down. They're going back to the same well. It's Hockenson again. First down now, but that clock rolling. To throw, Cousins. Throw left side, taken in by Jefferson. Touchdown! Justin Jefferson with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Cousins will try and throw. And they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. DuVernay now going to bring it out. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, still a good return. They'll start the drive right around the 37. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And with good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
Here's second and 10.
Jackson now. Blitz coming, and down he goes. The linebacker Jordan Hicks flying in there for the sack.
It's third and 15.
So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
All right, boys, let's keep it up.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half.
Well, CD, you understand. I mean, they're so eager trying to get back in this game here the fourth quarter, but they touched that one a little too early before it went 10 yards.
Brandon, in such a high-stakes scenario, everyone's feeling the pressure on this play. The special teams coordinator, which one is he going to pick in terms of kicks? Can the kicker execute it? Can the team wait for 10 yards? So many variables, and in this case, they didn't get it done.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Kirk Cousins with three touchdown passes now in the afternoon.
And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Kevin O'Connell choosing to leave his guys out there. They'll go for two.
Try and throw for it. This is caught. Was he in? Yes. 2 points. And I guess the touchdown wasn't enough. They want the onside kick as well. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it. it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. Throw left side complete. That's Mitchell. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
They're going to hurry back to the line now. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Really good coverage all over the field. It took away his intended read and almost dared him to try for his guy out of the backfield. No surprise on that one. It doesn't connect.
The second down and 10th there, knocked down as it leaves the cornerback's hand, and it's incomplete.
Got a fine line when you're setting up the screen. You don't want to throw it too early and have the defense react too quickly. And you definitely don't want to throw it too late, and that way it's not formed perfectly. Got to make sure you hit it just right.
On third down, Jackson. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
And he missed it. It's no good. And this will remain a two-touchdown game.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
That confidence is powerful, isn't it? You score one, you throw, you go back out there and get it done again. But what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in groove right now. They want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. Back-to-back sacks have this place in a frenzy as they line up again, third and long now. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Here is third and quite a ways. Cousins. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And this is going to be brought back for the Baltimore touchdown. This defense, Charles, they needed some type of a spark to help get them back in this game. I think they just got their spark.
No doubt about it. And you know, that's all they discussed. How can we get ourselves moving again? How can we get our team going? This definitely qualifies.
Tucker now to add the point after. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. Kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll look to throw here. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. And now they're in the hurry up. Cousins now from the 50. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. So now after the sack, Cousins and the Vikings come up here third and long. Looking to throw. That's down the field for Jefferson. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Vikings. Justin Jefferson, 64 yards. And the Vikings go up by two touchdowns. And there, Charles, he lined up out left, ran the post, caught it over the middle, and the rest, as they say, is history.
And you have to love the scheme that they just showed there, because if you're going to run a deep post, you ordinarily have to get a safety out of the middle of the field. And you do it one of two ways. Either by running routes at him that carries him away from it, or you either freeze him in the middle with routes that run underneath so that he doesn't get depth. Then you throw it over the top, and boy, what a successful play that was.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. This fielded right at the goal line. And able to get this out to the 25. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And really, Charles, not much of a surprise that they're losing. They just haven't been able to get much of anything going in the pass game. And as you well know, in today's NFL, if the passing game isn't working, usually not much else is working either.
You're exactly right about that, partner. And I know that right now the easy answer would be, hey, let's run the football. But that might not be everything you need. So despite the fact that they've struggled throwing it, they've got to find some type of a play. Multiple plays that puts the ball in the air. Success.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first. They'll set up to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Flowers. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. They go play action now. Jackson. And that's to the left sideline and incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
They'll try and throw for it with Jackson. Defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. Sliding out of the pocket. He lets one go deep for Addison. A poor decision there, and it's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Brandon Stevens. And the Ravens will take over here at their own 12-yard line. Their passing game has been spectacular this afternoon. Finally, a win for the defense.
You think maybe there was an adjustment there. Finally gained a measure of, I don't even know if you call it revenge, but got a play done against him, and that's been difficult for them all game long.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league,
and now the rookie's free. Off to the races. Moving inside the 20. And all the way in for the Ravens touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of the night. And the Ravens are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. And with his speed, if he just finds the slightest crease, he can take it the distance like he did there.
How about the leverage up front? Offensive line out leveraging the defensive front to create that space, that crease that he was looking for. And once he hits open field, he's going to be very difficult to catch and corral.
Now Tucker to add the PAT. And the lead will shrink to six. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And he's going to be brought down inside the five at the three.
Well, not exactly a banner return, so he doesn't give his offense a whole lot of room to work with. They've got to go a long way now to try and score some points. I do know this from experience. There will be a few comments muttered his way by the offense as they head out on the field.
Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay. They were already backed up. Now they're backed up further.
I think they were being so careful to make sure all assignments were covered that they ended up running themselves out of time.
Play clock down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium.
Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the Baltimore Ravens.
The kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone.
And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Start with a run by Mitchell.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Well, you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. Here's Jackson to throw. That's complete. It's Zay Flowers with it. And it's out to get this one across the field. 10 yards out, good enough for a Raven first down.
See the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Play action. It's Jackson.
A short one there, caught by Likely.
That'll go for a gain of 7, and that will bring up second down.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days, but you can flex him now. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target, and that's how he'll shred a defense.
4 yards the pickup, first down. Right back to Mitchell here. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line.
The tackle by N'Kobe Dean. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Touchdown, Mark Andrews, 45 yards,
and the Ravens put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets ahead of steam going, and as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
Scott on the return out of the end zone.
Now a hit and a loose football.
But it looks like one of the DBs has it.
And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
And in our meeting with the special teams coordinator, we asked him, what's your philosophy on bringing the ball out? Do you give them a red light? Do you keep them in? Green light, let them go? Let's see if he changes from green light to red light after that costly error.
Yeah, you know what I remember from that meeting? He brought donuts.
I like him.
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah,
but he's not happy right now.
No, don't tell everyone how many I have.
James Bradberry there to make the tackle.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, you throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
Right back to Mitchell on second down.
And they'll get him down right around the 16. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
They'll send the tight end in motion left. Now it's Jackson. And that'll be taken in by Andrews for a Ravens touchdown. A great effort there. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Ravens lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game. Tucker now for the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 13-0 first quarter lead. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
Scott on the return out of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 15. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. David Ojabo from his outside linebacker spot, forcing the sack for a loss of 8.
It may be cliche, but it is something that holds up over time, doesn't it? If you're the visitors, you don't want to let the crowd in the game early.
Yeah, and that's exactly what they did there. But you said also this defense, they're going to give them a lot of looks like we just saw there, aren't they?
They certainly are. They're a proud unit, and they're going to ride the momentum of this crowd with them. And that's why they got after them early.
22 yards there, a first down.
And time to give some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Throwing is Hurts. He's going deep for Brown. That's caught at the 25. And they're into the end zone, but it's not verified yet. Hold on, there is a flag down. So obviously they will decline the penalty there, and the result is 6 points. On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. And that one makes it 14-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And he will be taken down here as the first quarter of play will come to an end. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. They'll start this drive out on the ground. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it,
7 yards on first down. That fits the bill.
From the 35, here's second and three. Another run with Mitchell.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Throwing is Jackson. Throw caught by Flowers. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That one good for 13 and a Raven first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long. And that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. All right, Charles, as a former defensive back, how disheartening to actually catch it but just not be able to stay in bounds there defensively.
Well, extremely, because you know the rap against us defenders is that we're frustrated offensive guys who can't catch. And he caught it, just couldn't get his feet down in bounds. It's that second part that finished off the play for him.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Jackson on first down. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. They go play action with Jackson. Eluding the pressure right. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
They made a nice effort to stick him with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Jackson. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
I feel like my man Herb Moe, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a three and out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
Tucker's kick is good, and they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about one score lead, two score lead, etc., but this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They find themselves down 17-7 as they start this drive first and 10. Hurts throw taken in by Watkins here. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Here's Hurts to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Turns out to be a great idea to tuck that one. Good for 24 yards.
They asked him to take charge and get them to a spot where they could at least attempt a kick before the half.
and he does just that. Didn't trust what he saw downfield, so he took it upon himself to get them in the field goal range using his legs. That's coming through with a play they needed in a big spot.
Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. But first down, Hurts. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. A nice little screen. They get six on first down.
Good call there on first down. And Brandon, I'm getting better over the years of not screaming out screen, screen, screen with my defensive training. They want to keep those pass rushers honest, and they did so there, and they wind up picking up positive yardage.
Touchdown! DeAndre Swift from 10 yards out. And the Eagles get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Elliott Good with a PAT. And the lead's down to a field goal at 17-14. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And they may just be content to take this three-point lead and head into the locker room. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. Flushed out right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Third and two. Here's Jackson. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. This was the old NFL record distance for decades, a 63-yard attempt. Tucker's kick is good. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Side Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter.
Well, not one you see often there as he fails to keep it between the sidelines, and that is a penalty every time, and going to give this offense better field position.
And it's every kickoff guy's nightmare, isn't it? Because you don't see yourself doing this, and most of the time you don't. It's absolutely a mishit, and now your team pays the price. Bad field position for your defense.
And he's going to ball his way forward to the 48. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. From the gun, it's Hurts. Quick slant to Brown. There he goes, left side. Down to the 10. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A.J. Brown, 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far.
And the Eagles come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter.
Elliott good on the extra point, and that will put them on top here in the third. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
DuVernay now going to bring it out. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent is still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
Flush to his right.
There he goes again.
And down to the 28-yard line. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Oh, Lamar Jackson just so electric, Charles, when he gets into open space, and we saw Exhibit A right there.
You know something? I'm standing up here in the booth next to you watching the play. He buckled my ankles on that one as well. It doesn't matter whether you're actually on the field trying to chase him or you're just watching him play. This guy is sheer excitement.
On first and 10, it's Jackson. Eluding the pressure right. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. On second down, Jackson. Escaping the pressure right. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
Jackson from the shotgun. Forced out to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
At this point in the second half, one mistake on a forced throw could doom your chances of a comeback, so that's the right call there to just throw that one away.
A third quarter now, a one-point game as they line up second and 10.
Here's Jackson. Flushed out right. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Here's the seventh play in this drive. This is third and four. To throw is Jackson. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds.
First down, here's Mitchell.
And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out.
And the Ravens have retaken a third quarter lead. So a very strong first drive in the second half, Charles, as they turned that halftime deficit into a third quarter lead.
They were pretty purposeful there, weren't they? Measured in their approach. But boy, they executed awfully well, moving the ball down the field.
And he will get into the end zone again. And he seems to have a nose for it as he gets both the touchdown and the two-point conversion. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
On the return, Boston Scott. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
No score zone, no score zone.
On first and 10, it's Hurts.
And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him.
Multiple defenders in his first play, but found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
Well, they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it?
Oh, it's complete. A diving grab there by Brown. He's been big. Two touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts.
Just a gain of a couple there. And that'll make it second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts.
Going deep here for Watkins. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
Hurts.
Man over the left side is Brown. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the midfield.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. Into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked up by Jared Arden Davis. And the Ravens are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of. But so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action. Now's the time to take a shot.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. And we'll get to the 29-yard line brought down there. The offense on third down tonight, they've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This will be third and 15. Pass taken in by his big tight end. A solid stiff arm. And he's going to be out of bounds here all the way down inside.
Yo, these niggas, that's what they always do, bro.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium.
Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here as it'll be the Chicago Bears taking on the Baltimore Ravens.
Two men ready to do battle. It's time to dance. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially. So a net gain of one there.
Start on the ground here on first down.
That's to about the 28. Second down coming up.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Play action. Now Jackson. Being chased, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Sacked by Yannick Ngakoue, the former Maryland Terp.
The defense is always talking about not letting Lamar Jackson get comfortable. A good job there on his opening drive of making him uncomfortable.
And you're talking about doing it so early in the game because all week long there's been anxiety on the defensive side of the ball. How do we keep this guy hemmed in? How do we tackle?
I don't know what was going on there, but the end result, this is going to be a safety.
Well, two snaps ago, I don't think anyone thought a safety was on the table, yet it happened. They caught him on back-to-back plays breaking through the line. No amount of evading was going to save him from a sack on either play, and on the last one, he ran too deep into the end zone to set up the safety.
So a free kick situation forthcoming from the 20 as they'll punt this one away.
Oh, my goodness. Now that is going to be out of bounds on a free kick. Yeah, that's a big mistake. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10.
Right at the 50-yard line. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
From a couple of yards beyond midfield, here's second and 8. Now Fields.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8.
Fields now to throw.
Charles, but there's the negative side, a little loose with the football that time.
And that's normal, especially when you have his type of talents, because you feel like you're into the open field, and maybe you don't feel the people who are around you all closing in. All quarterbacks have to do extra ball security drills with the way the game's played now, because defenses, they attack the football as much as they attack the runner.
Again on 2nd and 10, it's Jackson. He's got the hook. Down Baker. Out across midfield, down to 42. 22 yards there. First down.
defenders.
And how about that start? Really aggressive. Yeah, there was double coverage out there, but that didn't stop them at all. They went right at it and defeated it on that play.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. First carry now for Justice Hill. Given three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Jackson now. Flush to his right. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
He's a talented runner, and that means he's always looking for bigger and bigger gains when he takes off. Certainly found some bonus yards there beyond the first down marker, and this early drive will continue with that extra jolt from his legs.
And the ball is knocked out, and this is picked up by the Bears. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they bring this one back. A fumble return for a Bears touchdown. And maybe that's the perils of being a rookie running back in the NFL. I mean, look, it's not easy to hold on to the ball at any level with these talented guys. But in this league, you can learn a lesson early.
Without a doubt, and what a tough reminder for any running back, especially a rookie, the things you got away with in college probably won't work so well in the NFL.
Following the fumble recovery, Fields, and unable to connect. They don't get the two-point conversion here. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And that last possession, really a gut punch. You seemingly had it working. You were in the midst of a very strong drive and suddenly the fumble. And you're watching the back of a defender's jersey as he brings it all the way in the other direction.
There's not much more I can add to that. I thought you summarized it perfectly, partner. You've just got to regroup and start putting another drive together. That's all you can do.
Now it's Jackson. That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 22 yards there, a first down. One quarter down, 8-0 the score.
With the score, Bears 8, Ravens nothing.
Second quarter now from Baltimore. It's the Ravens in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. Here's Jackson to throw. And this one's incomplete.
That open man that time, they end up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Jackson. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. It'll be a loss of only a couple on the sack, but now it'll bring up third down. Now after that sack, it's third and long for Jackson and the Ravens. And the tight end goes in motion left. From midfield now, here's Jackson. Under pressure, they got him again. Montez Sweat. That is now two sacks for him here in this first half. So that now four first-half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
Partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's the game plan that they've had so far, because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
To return is Taylor. So a change of possession here on the punt. And it'll be first and 10 Bears from deep in their own territory.
That punt was near perfection as it checked up inside the 5-yard line. You never know where these things are going to go, do you?
No. What was it? You got a John Heisman quote about that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he said the football is roughly a prolate spheroid, which means it's going to bounce funny, and you never know where it's going to end up.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. From his goal line here, Fields. They'll roll him out right. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that. Well, that would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
And that is not what you expect from a receiver of his caliber. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself. You don't look it in, and all of a sudden it's on the ground. A surprise to all.
He's going to look deep for more. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Chicago. DJ Moore, 95 yards, and the Bears have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and the lead is up to 15 now. After the touchdown, here's the punter Trenton Gill to kick it away. Duvernay now going to bring it out.
Devin Duvernay on the return. The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
The last series for him, a little disappointing, forced a punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10.
Meanwhile, Jackson's throw is on target to Likely. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Now Jackson on second down. Toward the sideline. Look at that catch. Dragging the toes. It's going to be a first down. 15 yards. He'll make the play as they try to chip away at this 15-point deficit.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Back-to-back good plays. Have them on the move on first down. From the gun, it's Jackson. Throw right side here, taken in by Bateman. Now he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. So 8 yards on the completion there. Yeah, that'll bring up a second down and just a couple. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
From the 46, here's second and 2.
Jackson. To the left side, it's caught by Mitchell. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. First down now, but that clock rolling. Throwing is Jackson. Dancing to his left. And he'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Jackson trying to hustle his unit up quickly to the line of scrimmage. Now Lamar changing the play. To the right side, into the hands of Flowers. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. Now a second and 6. Now it's Jackson. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number 1. So it's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive. Here's Jackson. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They'll try to run with Mitchell. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Ravens get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Just power football there down near the goal line. Give it to him. He's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come in, have to report like they're eligible.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Fields. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
But he certainly didn't like what he saw all from the coverage on his primary reads, and he didn't even have any luck trying to get back to his safety valve. Give defense a credit. Coverage is in lockdown mode everywhere.
Here's Fields. And this throw incomplete. The defender all over at that time, but it's going to lead to third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Now yet another incompletion here as
they fail to stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They could compete with the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four. They snap it to Fields. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Escaping the pressure right. Catch up to him and take him down. Chief, where was he going? Huge loss there.
You know, I know the sacked offense is momentum, but normally when you get sacked, you're losing 5, 8, 10 yards. On a really bad play, 15, how do you lose about half a field on a play? Unbelievable.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
One of the great coaches said football is a really simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, and a long way to go on third down. A shotgun snap, Fields. He'll fire deep, looking for more. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams, and he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Arthur Davis, and the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Not the way you envision things to start out the third quarter. One play and already a turnover.
It's interesting. You and I were talking with the coach, and he talked about how at halftime, as a play caller, he wanted to make sure he got a new script going for the second half, not just the one that he operated off of to start the game. Nowhere on that script did it have that result.
And quickly, they get to the line. To throw is Jackson. And that is incomplete. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
Over the middle to Beckham. And he'll get this only to about the 38 as they stop him a few yards shy of the line to gain.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield.
Well, the 3 points certainly helps, but you feel like, Charles, at this stage of the game, when you force those turnovers, you need to start converting them into touchdowns.
Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised myself because I thought in this situation, they were thinking end zone or bust. Now they got to rely on their defense to get the ball back again for another opportunity to get 6 points.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
The last drive for this offense, Charles, you remember it ended in one play, that quick interception, but they do still have the lead as they start this drive here.
And that's something to focus on for them as well, because it's not quite no harm, no foul, but the interception, hey, shake it off, move on. Hasn't cost your team the lead, and now it's time to rebound, and the quarterback and his teammates, they can add to the lead.
The ball comes out, and this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well. Second time he's fumbled in this game. Fortunate for him, this one goes out of bounds.
And the key for him now is how much equity have you built up with your coaching staff? How much equity have you built up with your team to continue?
Oh, Fields is intercepted for a third time. Picked up by Jalen Arthur Davis. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
So this whole game gets flipped on its ear right there. The interception, return for a touchdown, and this lead changes hands here in the third quarter.
And it certainly felt like this defense had a read on what was going on the offensive side of the ball and said, let's cut down our coverage a little bit. Let's be in a position to make a play on the ball. And boy, that sure turned out well for them.
And he is going to be stopped short of the goal line. Oh, they'll mark him inside the one. He just couldn't keep churning those extra few inches. And the two-point attempt is turned aside.
Scott on the return, out of the end zone.
And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right,
throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership.
Throwing on third down, Fields. Work in the middle of the field, he's got a man complete.
And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Now a first down throw, Fields.
That complete, hits Tyler Scott with it. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. And they're going to speed things up here.
Fields changing the play.
So it looks like somebody may have forgotten the snap count.
and a 5-yard penalty ensues. Oh, jumping early from his tight end spot. Maybe trying to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
Flushed out right. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And the Ravens will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. They'll start this drive out on the ground. Now inside the 25. And finally wrestled down at the 11. 130 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. So you got the lead here in the second half. Obviously, you love big runs like that at any time. Here, you really like it.
And how about the confidence that's being exhibited by that offense now? They don't care what you're lining up doing on the defensive side. They want the big fella to carry the football and carry it often.
Steps away to his left. Checks this one down. It's Mitchell. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. From the 5, 2nd and 4. Jackson's going to keep it. And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down. Back now in Baltimore. This one's still anybody's ball game. It's a 1-point difference here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Flush to his right. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Ravens are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. This defense, so many things to worry about in the red zone area, but you'd have to almost think that Lamar Jackson running the football, that might be number one.
It should be number one, and in this portion of the field where things shrink a little bit because the receivers can't run blocks, but he has his own real estate. You should have Lamar Jackson when the ball is snapped and try and keep him back in the pocket.
Yeah, I don't think that they were surprised he was running it there. They just couldn't stop him, and he ends up in the end zone. Taking it about the 1. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a 1-possession game, down 8. They'll be looking for the touchdown and 2-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage. Movement there on the offensive line, a little quick, and a 5-yard penalty. The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
The false start backs them up 5, 1st and 15. Now it's Fields. And oh my goodness, here's a 5th interception. Picked off by Roquan Smith. And they'll start the
game.
Position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. And I'm starting to wonder, Charles, if 5 interceptions, is that the last that we've seen of him?
Because this motherfucker over.
That's the last they've seen of him in this game, probably including himself. If this were baseball.
Pressure and he's taken down. A bear sack. DeMarcus Walker. Able to collapse the pocket, get to him, and drop him for a loss of a yard. The sack cost him only a yard. It's 2nd and 11. Jackson now. And it's caught. It throws. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A first down there on a pickup of 25. Gun, a run for Hill. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. First and goal.
Play action. It's Jackson.
There's Flowers. He's got it. Touchdown, Ravens.
A 9-yard touchdown there. And the Ravens.